Welcome, Bot Builders. This is Aryan from Botpress. Have you ever opened Slack and instantly regretted it? Messages everywhere and someone's asking for a link from 3 days ago. Well, it's not that people are lazy. It's just that Slack was built for chatting and while going the extra mile for collaboration requires efforts. That's where a Slackbot comes in. It brings in the right tools into the chat so anyone can trigger these tools despite the department. In this video, I'll show you how to build a bot that connects to Slack, listens for some real triggers and uses that information for something useful for your team. Before you build anything, we need to ask ourselves a simple question. What exactly should this bot do? I'm going to be building a simple Slack bot that helps you track ongoing sales deals, inspired by one that we are using here internally at Botpress called Super CRO. It connects to your CRM, pulls in key information, and posts a clean summary back into Slack. Things like what the client wants, who the decision maker is, what is the timeline and the budget. And once you have that scope, we can start building the chatbot. So I'll meet you in Botpress. Once inside Botpress, we're going to start by adding clear instructions telling the bot who it is and how it should behave. My instructions would look something like this, which essentially tells the bot that it's an internal lead qualification assistant. It should look for whatever the company name mentioned in the messages in the knowledge base and give information back regarding that. So let's go ahead and save it. As far as the knowledge goes, what is knowledge? Knowledge is basically the information that is out of the scope of what the chatbot already knows. It can be something specific to your company, like your website, documents, or you can even go ahead and connect Notion, Drive, HubSpot, CRMs, anything as your knowledge base. Ideally, since we are doing lead generation, knowledge should have access to your HubSpot CRM, but since it's a simple tutorial, I'm going to be just making a dummy lightweight version of it where we are going to be making it through tables. To do that, you can head over to tables, create a new table, let's call it leads, and save it. In leads, you're going to import an existing list of deal summaries that we have, and let me show you how it looks like. So this is what our table looks like. It has the name of the clients, deal stage, deal value, assigned rep, next steps, etc. So once we have that, to add this table to your chatbot, all you have to do is head over to your knowledge bases, add this table as part of the knowledge base, and here we should already see it. We have our basic version of chatbot ready. So let me just quickly show you how you can deploy this on Slack. Now that the bot knows what to do and where to get its information from, let's get into Slack deployment. It's pretty simple. So all you have to do is go to communication channels below knowledge base and select Slack. After selecting Slack, you can go ahead and install the integration that adds the integration to your workspace. So once the integration is installed, you can go ahead and authorize Slack, which should open up the server list for you to choose where you want this bot to be deployed. Choose the server that we want to deploy the bot on and just simply allow it. All right, so we are here in Slack. Let's make sure the chatbot is in our channel first. You can just do that by calling it and adding it to the channel. Okay, we can start by asking a very simple question. I believe one of the companies in the table is called Orbit Systems. So let's ask it if it knows anything about Orbit Systems. That's the emoji that I was mentioning. It basically shows that the chatbot has seen the message. There you can see it can come up with information about whatever was added to our knowledge base. We can even counter question it and ask it to reveal more details about the knowledge base and the task that we are looking at. So deal value is a pretty interesting field over here. So let's ask it to reveal all the deals that are above 50K. So what are the deals? So it should indulge in a conversation with you and answer all the stuff. So that's pretty good. So there you have it. Our basic version of the chatbot is working pretty seamlessly on Slack. The best thing about this type of deployment is that you don't have to deal with a lot of APIs or write any code from your own end. So now that the basic version of the bot is ready, let's go ahead and add something cool functionality to it, which will make people actually use the bot. For me, it's going to be triggering a message or a workflow from just a reaction in Slack, which will essentially let us start a process by just reacting to it. So let's go ahead and look at that. Now that the chatbot has deployed, let's go ahead and see how you can start calling it. To do that, we can simply select workflows from the menu on the left side, and let's create some space for us to work in. So I'm going to try to keep things as similar to the first one as possible. The first things first, we are expecting the messages to start by a reaction, so not just a simple message. So we can go ahead and remove the connection to the start node and instead create a trigger. The trigger card is triggered when there is a new reaction added to a message which the bot was already looking at. So to do that, you can press right click, trigger, and reaction added. Once we have all the information coming in, we can extract the details that are relevant to our task over here. So let's go ahead and create a standard node where we are going to be extracting all the details from that events API call that I had mentioned earlier. So in this, we are going to add a new execute code card. Execute code card just lets you add code, which lets you manipulate stuff. So create some empty workflow variables. Once we have that, we should also go ahead and add all of these guys as variables. Once the variables have been added, let me connect our trigger to the extraction card over here. Now in this extraction node, we are going to add a card which will let it retrieve the message that was associated with the reaction that was sent to us. You can go ahead and click the retrieve message card and add it to the extraction node. Now you see there are two basic things that it is asking for. First is going to be the timestamp. We have already extracted the timestamp using the first card and saved it in the variable. And with that, we have all of our information regarding the message that was associated with the reaction. We can just pass this knowledge to the autonomous node, which will then be able to use the information. Change our instructions a bit so that we account for the new reaction-based triggering, to ask it to only trigger when the reaction is a bug. That helps organize it better. You can go ahead and attach more functions to different emojis using this simple method. And finally, I'm going to be adding a small statement at the end that will ask the chatbot to use the workflow transition tool when the user's queries are met. Workflow transition is basically a way for the node to end the conversation. We can go ahead and add a card called transition to it, which will essentially let you control when the conversation ends. So to show you the new example, I've created a new Slack channel, and let's do the same exact thing. Call Botpress in. I have a name of a webs of a company already written on the chat. Now, I don't want the chatbot to directly answer to this. Instead, what I want is that I react to this message with a bulb, and then it should be giving me the information. And there it is. Just like that, you have turned a casual Slack message into a trigger. What we have built here is a starting point. The tools and flows that I've showed you here are intentionally simple and focused. Because they are designed to be combined, you can layer on approvals, handovers, database calls, any other APIs that you want to work with. If you get stuck somewhere specific, or if there's a workflow you're trying to build in WordPress, drop it in comments. And thanks for watching. Until next time, happy bot building.